Okay friends, so today I've got a very interesting script. The name is Mahanagar Gas Limited, MGL. I've titled this video as the turtle story. Slow and steady wins the race. So it's a very interesting information on Mahanagar Gas Limited. It has been 5 years since the inception for this company. It's India's leading natural gas, one of India's leading natural gas distribution companies with an extensive city gas distribution network of pipelines. Incorporated on 8th May 1995, MGL was promoted by GAIL Limited and PGAC Pacific Holdings Limited. However, the exit of PGAC Pacific Holdings Limited in August 2019, so GAIL became GAIL with a 32.5% shareholding, is currently the sole promoter of MGL, and Government of Maharashtra has remained associated with MGL since inception and currently holds 10% in MGL. So we have got very strong promoters as far as Government of Maharashtra is concerned and GAIL is concerned. Now it has got a track record of 100% reliability as far as gas supply is concerned. Even during the difficult times, that is of the devastating floods of Mumbai, when everything was standstill, when most of the other utilities failed, MGL's gas supply continued uninterrupted. Now this shows the strength of the company infrastructure even in the most difficult times. MGL has an experience over 25 years in supplying natural gas by way of compressed natural gas to vehicles and piped natural gas to domestic, commercial and industrial consumers in Mumbai, its adjoining areas and Raigarh district in Maharashtra. So basically it is doing CNG and PNG. That's the basic business of this company. Now it is an ISO certified company. So it has got three certifications, basically ISO 9001, 14001 and 18001. Now 9001 is on the quality management systems. The 14001 is on the environmental management, and 18001, that is OSAS, is on the occupational health and safety. So it has got certification, international certifications on its belt. Now your area of operations, business operations, are Mumbai and the Greater Mumbai. Then they have got Mira, Bhayandar, Navi Mumbai, Thane City, Kalyan, Taloja, Ambernath, Dombivli, Utlapur, Bhiwandi, Khargar and Panvel. And they have got some exclusivity by Raigarh district, adjacent existing area to the operation. They've got this exclusivity till 2040, and even if a new player comes to come in, it is very difficult without the infrastructure of MGL. So MGL pipeline is basically 5,631 kilometers. This cannot be built in 1 year, 2 year, 3 years or 4 year. It needs time, 10 years hopefully. The connections of piped natural gas PNG is 1.48 million. The CNG stations are 256, and MGL CNG customers are 0.75 million. So they have built a very good customer base which keeps on growing on a day to basis or a quarter quarter basis or an annual basis. I want to make this video short, but I don't think it's possible because there's so much information here. It is one of the largest CGD companies in India, that is city gas distribution company in India. Sole authorized distributor of CNG and PNG in Mumbai in adjacent areas, Raigarh, with more than 25 years track record in Mumbai. Cost effective ability of domestic natural gas with sourcing flexibility. It has supplied 0.75 million vehicles, as we discussed, approx 1.48 million domestic household, 5,600 km pipeline. Revenues at a compounded annual growth rate of 7.2%, return on net worth 26.87%. It has a net worth of 29.53 billion Indian rupees. So that's a big one, big company, strong company. GAIL owns 32.5%, Government of Maharashtra owns 10%, rest is with public and the institutions. Now this is the investment rationale of the company. You see this sheet and you will be 100% confident to invest in this script for a longer period of time. You see, this is a 25 year journey. In 1995, it was initiated, the company, inception of the company. 2000, they are 38,300 PNG connections, and on this date, basically on 2020, they have 12,60,000 connections. So look at this gradual, stupendous, fantastic rise of PNG connections. In the same way, they have got the infrastructure. So in 1995 inception, in 2000, they had only 536 kilometers of pipeline. And till today, they have 5,630 kilometers of pipeline. So this is the infrastructure they built in 20 years. And no company can build it in 5, 10 years. Yeah, it will take time. The CNG outlets are, in 2000, they were 21 outlets. Currently, they are having 256 outlets. So this shows the growth of the company as far as the connections are concerned, as far as the infrastructure is concerned, as far as the CNG outlets are concerned. Phenomenal story, slow moving, but slow and steady wins the race. Until the turtle story is basically the same thing. It moves like a turtle, slow and steadily, but it has made good progress. So this is what we discussed. They have 1.27 million household customers. They have over 3,956 small commercial establishments, 75 industrial establishment. Okay, and they have 0.75 million vehicles in Mumbai, you know, adjacent areas, above 0.35 million rickshaws, taxis of around 0.06 million, 0.32 million of cars. Then these are the public transport, yeah, around 2011, and about 7,000 tempos, trucks and private. Okay, this shows the overall growth of the company, and they have about 5,100 kilometers of PE pipeline. PE is polyethylene, basically 257 CNG filling stations and 1,518 dispensing points. And this is just the beginning, you know, the way Mumbai behaves, although it is COVID currently and the business is a bit lagging, but eventually it is going to out to be a superstar or a very good, fundamental, strong company. So during the COVID, the earning conference call was done, and these are the basic important information which was captured from that conference call transcript. Basically, in March 2020, the pandemic was named as the pandemic. Characterized the outbreak of the strain of the novel coronavirus as pandemic. Everything was standstill. India was locked. Nobody is moving out. Nobody is coming in. So the consumption story was at the full stop. Yeah. The company's operations were impacted for the full quarter, resulting in reduction of sales, except for gas consuming household connection. Only the household connection were consuming the gas. The rest, CNG, all stopped. Yeah. However, the daily sales volume had increased from 25% in April to 55% in July, compared to the normal volume recorded during pre-lockdown. Sales have further improved to 65% level in the month of August, and this is expected to further pick up. So things are getting good for the company because we are getting used to the COVID situations. In 2020, the reimposition of the strict lockdown municipal areas like this impeded the construction work of the whatever capex they are having. As a result of the lockdown throughout the quarter, volumes were adversely impacted, resulting in reduction in overall sales volume of the quarter by 60%. That's huge. As a result, current EBITDA is 80 crore as compared to 244 crores. This shows earnings before the interest, tax, depreciation and amortization. Yeah. So that is what. So it has reduced drastically. On margin from EBITDA was at 30% for quarter one compared to previous EBITDA of 35%. Expenses per CGM sold at high mainly due to overheads remaining at normal levels with reduced volumes. Net profit was 45 crores as compared to 167 crores. This clearly shows the business was down, and was significantly down due to COVID. Now this is again a transcript which has been taken from there. Now if you see, there were some queries with reference to the use of the consumption story of the Mahanagar Gas Limited. So management has clarified that for diesel we take it almost same as the pricing of CNG works, about 35% to 37% cheaper than diesel. So it is 35 to 37% cheaper than diesel, whereas petrol engine CNG gives almost 50 to 20% of higher mileage compared to petrol. So it is good in every aspects. It is better than diesel, it is better than petrol as well. Then there was another, these are, you know, important points as far as business is concerned, because this gives the reason for CNG to continue as a business, yeah, and solid business. Now the second point is, like, if the commercial vehicle is less than 8 years old, it is allowed to run on diesel. But if it is older than 8 years, it cannot run in Mumbai. It has to be converted to CNG. You know, just if you can guess, if the vehicle is more than 8 years, then it has to run on CNG, or the guy has to buy a new diesel vehicle. So this is the mod, like this is the cream of the business. Every vehicle that gets more than 8 years is compulsory has to be CNG vehicle, yeah. And this is applicable for all commercial vehicles, yeah. Just understand this single terminology, a single statement can change the whole business. It can change the view or perception of a person towards the business of the company. And the other thing is, this slide I have taken from the same, you know, this transcript, the earlier one. So there it shows that this company, one of the owner of Vitram Gas, yeah, he has been telling that they have been manufacturing the glass bottles for the pharmaceutical industry since 1967. They had signed an agreement with MGL in 1999. We are a continuous process industry. In the last two decades, we have worked uninterruptedly with only three shutdowns for major repairs for the furnace and the machines. Except the shutdowns, we have been continuously producing 24 hours a day, and naturally they require fuel continuously. So they are having uninterrupted supply of gas by MGL since last 20 years, and we have never faced any problem with MGL in our entire history. So this shows the strong infrastructure they have and the confidence their customers are having on MGL, yeah. That is the reason I put this slide. There is no other reason to put the slides. This shows the confidence in the business of the company and the customer confidence. Look at this. This gives you immense confidence to invest. Like when it was incepted, the net worth of the company was 0.76 billion Indian rupees, and now it is 29.5 billion Indian rupees in a span of maybe 20 years. Yeah. It has been a tremendous growth at a CAGR, a compound annual growth of 18.1%. in 22 years. Now this is the diversified sourcing strategy of MGL. Basically the source is APM and non-APM, yeah. That is for the CNG and the domestic PNGs, compressed natural gas and piped natural gas, and industrial and commercial PNG. That is, they have got a term RLNG and they have got a spot RLNG. So RLNG stands for the regasified liquefied natural gas, and spot regasified liquefied natural gas, yeah. So API is basically the administered price mechanism, and the suppliers are Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas and GAIL. So there are two suppliers for MGL, Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas and GAIL. So for domestic supply agreement, they have got the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. With allocation of 110% of consumption, is they have got with GAIL, price to be fixed on 6 month basis. Okay, so this is interesting. For this degasified liquefied natural gas, they have got a term contract with BPCL, Hajira LNG, PLL, and for spot LNG, they have got with gas, GAIL, HPCL, IOCL, TPL. So there's a mix of spot and term contracts. This is how they are sourcing, and this is their sourcing strategy. This is an overview, industry overview, that India was the third largest energy consumer in the world after China and US in 2019. Consumption increased by 58%. Now if you see this CGT, that is compressed natural gas sector, to grow faster as natural gas becomes preferred fuel, they'll just shown at like 2015, they had a CAGR of 11% compounded annual growth of 11%, then 9%, now close to 12% by 2030. And with increased government focus, environmental initiative, PNG CNG corridor, CNG expansion in new cities, this industry is going to do really well in future as well. Infrastructure, they have got an asset base fixed of 25 billion Indian rupees, and the capex of 2020 is 2.9 billion, CNG customer base of 0.75 million, PNG customer base of 1.48 million, 256 CNG filling station, 182 with OMCs, 74 with MGL and its franchise, the pipeline of 5 and CGS of 5,600 kilometers of pipeline, 5 city gate stations, tariff flexibility, infrastructure exclusivity for Mumbai till 2020, adjoining areas till 2030, Raigarh till 2040. So these are the new areas and the new fortunes or game changers for this company. And MGL has established widespread network plans for expansion to enter new areas and increase penetration in the existing business. So when a company is growing and has the areas to grow in business, it is obviously a buy for long-term perspective. This shows the same old data which we discussed. The customer base has increased year on year from FY15 to 2020. The PNG customer growth base, the CNG customer growth base, the CNG volume has grown as a CAGR of 3.9%. The PNG volume has grown as a CAGR of 5.5%. Yeah. So this all terminology I've explained to you earlier. CNG is compressed natural gas, PNG is piped natural gas. And this is MMSCD, MD is the unit of the gas supply. Yeah. So unit of the volume. Yeah. So this is how. Basically, it stands for metric million British thermal unit. Yeah. So this is how the company has been growing at a constant CAGR, slow but consistent. This is the revenue and profitability. 5 year CAGR of CNG is 8.7, PNG is 4.3, CAGR total 7.2. So this is how the revenue is increasing. The gross profit is also increasing. It's not decreasing. That's very good part. Yeah. Because it's a growing company, it has more area to grow. Profitability as far as Indian rupees is concerned, FY15 it was 4.9 billion, FY20 is 10.5 billion, so it has doubled. Yeah, PAT has also doubled, 3 billion Indian rupees to 7.9 billion rupees in FY15 to FY20. This is the balance sheet of the company, which shows a very good growth from 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020, which I've highlighted in yellow. Look at the revenue front, they've increased. From profitability, they have increased. Net profit margin has increased. Operated profit margin have increased. Yeah, everything is increasing at a slow and a steady pace. If you see the shareholding, they have got government as a shareholder. They have got GAIL as a shareholder. FIIs, FPIs are holding 31%. Mutual funds are holding 7.9%. Other public is holding 18.3%. So it is in strong hands, I believe. The government as well as GAIL. GAIL is also government listed company, government owned company. So it's a very good, it is in the hands of very good stakeholders. The only issue is the government policies sometimes may change, but the business is superb, man. It's growing slowly and steadily. Beautiful business. Okay, the conclusion of this video. MGL is a buy on all depths, rock solid business with good management, consistent performance history, solid future prospects and all perspective. It's a buy for a long term time frame, not a short term. Short term everything goes up down. We don't care for the short term, but over a longer term it is going to be rocking business. Steady, consistent performance. And I'll also share the technical chart recommendations in my next video soon. On the technical front, this is on the fundamental front. I hope you guys like the information which I've shared in this video. Okay, this is a disclaimer which I put after every video. This is purely for education purpose. This is not stock recommendation. Everyone should do their due diligence before investing. I do own few stocks, so my views can be biased, is biased. This is my personal view, and everyone should take the decision on any stock I talk about by doing my own independent research. Views are based on current scenario and the company's based and currently I'm merely sharing my opinion with no guarantee of gains or losses on this investment. So hope the information which I shared with you, hope you guys like it. It is fundamentally the best company one of the best companies which are listed on the bourses with consistent performance. It delivered in the past, it will deliver in future because it has more room to grow, as it has areas which they have still a lot of areas to be captured. Revenue will increase, profitability will increase over longer time frame. Newcomers cannot offset them because the infrastructure is not there for the newcomers. Even if newcomers come, then they have to take the infrastructure from them on lease. So this company is going to rock in future. Hope you like this video, friends. If you have any comments, put it in the comment box. Thank you.